Shenton Team 2 remains the only team to go undefeated this far into the Flak Test High School Esports Regional League season for 2018. And today, two teams, Indonesia's SMA1 PSKD and Perth's Balladura Community College, stand in the way of making it 8 rounds straight. Let's go. Hello and welcome to the Flak Test feature match of the week. Thanks to our mates at AOC. I am Pete Frequency Corelli. Joined in cast today on twitch.tv/flaktest. And thank you for joining us by Ben Styrell Brooks. And Styrell, we've got a massive doubleheader for everybody watching today. Shenton Team 2, the only undefeated team so far this season. Why? How? How have they done it?
Well, to start off, they've been playing together since February, so about 3 months together so far. But there are a few things that stand out to me. So, comparatively to the other teams that we've casted so far in this Overwatch season, their ranks are higher than the other teams we've seen. They're averaging around high platinum, but their team captain has made it to Grandmaster. So,
wow, that is incredible.
Yeah, and he's on main tank, so that experience should really show in like his shot calling and his ability to guide his team. Mm-hmm. Speaking of guiding teams, their teacher apparently actually understands a fair amount about the game, and he goes and watches their matches and reviews and analyzes like the mistakes they make and the mistakes enemy teams make to build off of that.
Their teacher representative for the high school esports club?
Yeah.
Okay, very heavily involved over there at Shenton.
So they do VOD reviews. And one last thing I want to mention. They consult with professional player Tung.
Tung.
He plays for Blank Esports, the best team in Australia, and is also in the top two aim supports trialing for the World Cup Australia team.
That is unreal. And for those of you who have been across the Flak Test regional leagues for the past couple of years, you might actually remember Tung as somebody who participated in the Flak Test High School Esports League last year as we trialed Overwatch as well, which is very exciting. Now, before we get into the match, I just want to quickly mention something. We've got a massive announcement coming your way about how we're going to roll out the Regional League Grand Finals, okay, a little bit later on. You're going to hear that once we're finished with the doubleheader today, so do not go anywhere. It involves announcements about how those Grand Finals are going to be played, where they're going to be played, who they're going to be played in front of, broadcast, and also some incredible prizes that we've got to give away thanks to our mates at AOC as well. So make sure you stick around for that. Let's get stuck into this. As I mentioned, a doubleheader as we move across to Game Cam right now. After this one, it's going to be Shenton taking on Balladura Community College, but we're going to kick things off with Shenton and Indonesia's SMA1 PSKD. It's a best of three maps in the Overwatch Regional League for Flak Test High School Esports Clubs. And we're kicking things off with hybrid map Numbani.
Yeah, there's only one thing I like better than casting a match of Overwatch, and that's casting two back-to-back matches of Overwatch.
Oh, man, I'm ready. I couldn't agree more. To the left of your screen, in blue, you're going to see Shenton, Overwatch Team 2, and in red, it's PSKD from Indonesia as we go through the different picks. Tell us what you're looking at.
So looking at Shenton's for the defensive side, you can tell they've been consulting with Tung. It's a very very educated, very meta composition for first point Numbani defense. Looking over at the attacking side, PSKD, obviously they're just memeing around right now. You know, they have 56 seconds to spare. They can pick Symmetra, you know, bait it out for the lols or whatever. So we'll have to just wait and see what they're actually going to pick.
Mm-hmm. Good lols. So many good lols right now. Out of those, okay, let's. Well, we've got 40 seconds, right?
Yeah.
Out of those, who do you reckon they're going to stick with, and who do you reckon they're going to change up?
I think they. Okay. Could
well, there's
stick with
one
the
already.
They're going to stick with the D.Va.
There's their first tank.
They're probably going to stick with the Moira over Ana, I'm going to say. Ana isn't really used very much on the offense. Numbani first.
Mm-hmm.
You can see a nice little conga line, you know, building that team spirit, that team synergy. You can really see the teamwork coming out from Shenton right now.
Yeah,
a very well-organized conga line with the melees to follow. Hanzo leading the charge.
Great to see Mert picking up the Pharah. I like a Pharah on this map. It's really nice the way that this map actually sorts itself out. You've got some really great areas that you can duck behind for cover for a Pharah. So
yep,
good to see that pick.
We can finally see the finished composition. Looks like it's going to be a triple DPS composition for the side of PSKD. And we started off here with Pharah just getting some cheeky spam. Gets 13% on the ult, so you know, take it for free. Take your wins where you get them. Winston looking for the peek, looking for the dive in. Sees the Zen, but he's taken heavy poke. That's going to force out the bubble. This is not a good start for PSKD. Winston's jumping in with 100 HP. He gets taken out by the Hanzo. Zenyatta dropping low, gets taken out by the Widow. And this looks like a pretty convincing first fight win for the side of Shenton. Unfortunately, Winston just took too much poke in that initial engage. Couldn't get the jump off the way he wanted it. Had to waste his bubble, then jumped in on 100 HP.
Yeah.
That's the start of a losing fight right there.
Not 100% sure what was going on there with PSKD. They did look like they had a bit of a split going on.
Yeah, they have the Lucio, so if you want to go for a play like that, you need to be speed boosting to minimize the poke that you're going to take.
Thanks for
speed boosting into the dive. They also don't have an off tank here, so their Winston's really relying on that fast take, that fast push in. As Pharah by herself right now doesn't have the Mercy pocket, so off a couple of directs a hit just like that. Merp's going to be getting a free pick at the start, but needs to watch out. That Widowmaker is hitting her shots right now. Lucio trying to back up as it looks like this fight is lost. Hanzo gets the cheeky pick. Rez comes out on the Pharah. So despite that amazing direct from Merp, she does get resurrected regardless, but it doesn't matter. Because too many players were picked yet again.
First ult rotation coming up very nicely for Shenton Team 2, who are defending right now. The Pharah ult, the Hanzo ult, and the Mercy ult all in the bag.
Yep. Could potentially just be using the barrage if she finds a good opportunity to use it, but Mercy ult is perfectly fine to expend here. There's not really anything coming up for the side of PSKD besides the Lucio ult and Valkyrie right now. Potentially a Junkrat ult coming through, but finally they have picked up themselves a D.Va, so they will be taking this high gun control, but the D.Va dropping low gets demeked. Winston's on the low ground. Hanzo going to be picking him up by the looks of it. No, he jumps up, gets out of there, but a beautiful shot onto the mini D.Va, and that's two players down, I believe, for PSKD, so they're resetting yet again, just trying not to stagger their respawns. And it's another reset.
Saw the first opportunity there for PSKD to try something. They did try a bit of a dive there. Didn't quite work out for them. They're just not being supported very well at this point.
No, once the beat drop going to be coming out from PSKD. They do want to commit to this fight, apparently. It looks like they have the Mercy ult as well. They're going to be committing the Valkyrie. They have to win this fight. They've committed too many resources. Winston just putting pressure on the point, but the opposing Primal Rage coming out. Also making sure that point is contested. Winston dropping low for the side of Shenton, but jumps up, dashes away, gets the healing. Pharah has the barrage if it's needed, but doesn't look like it's going to be. Oh, you hate to see resources expended like that without a proper plan. It looks like they just committed as much as they could in hopes that they could get the point, but you could tell there was no clear plan. I think they were a player or two down and they just dumped their load, you know, trying
a little bit unfortunate for SMA1 PSKD there, because they did get the Mercy down on that team fight.
Oh, really?
They did get the Mercy down, and they did have an opportunity to keep pushing. They almost got the Winston and the D.Va out of her mech as well, but couldn't quite do it.
Yep, and the D.Va, Luxuria on that D.Va for PSKD, gets D-mech'd. Soldier getting picked off by the Pharah. You can't be peeking like that if you need a reset on your D.Va mech. But Junkrat looking for the flank, could be getting a huge tie here, could make all the difference. Going to be coming up for the high ground tunnel. We'll have to see if he can get the pick on the Hanzo, potentially more. Just gets the Hanzo pick, but D.Va looks like he knows where that Riptide came from, looking for the pick. Lucio going to be taken down on the point. Only 5 seconds left on this point. The Pharah barrage comes through, picks up the Junkrat. The visor could come out from the high ground, but no. He's forced to back off as the Pharah, the pressure from the Pharah. It's just too overwhelming.
Great defensive round there by Shenton. They just had all the answers for SMA1 PSKD. As I mentioned before, there was a bit of a push going on for SMA1 when they did manage to get the Mercy down, and they got both the Winston. They got the Winston down to within maybe 5% of his HP, and they got the D.Va down to almost a D-meching, but just couldn't quite complete them. If that happened with about a minute left to go on the map, They had all three of those down at one time. They possibly could have taken out that map, but yet again, Shenton just showing that clout there and managing to hold.
Yeah, probably just a little bit of misguided target focus split between the team. If you're not all focusing the same target, then that tends to happen. You know, both enemy tanks, they get so low, but you just don't finish them because your focus is split. It's quite unlucky. Oh, wow. I'm sure they can work on that coming into the second round.
Back into the prepare. We've seen a bit of a change up for the attacking side here this time around, pulling out the Doomfist for Ben Mozzie.
Yeah, they did get 46.5%, so they can still full hold this.
Mm-hmm.
They did get just over a single tick. The most important thing coming from a player is to not tilt. You know, you can't get demotivated, you can't get tilted from being full held like that, because that is the thing that's going to make you lose.
Look, at the end of the day, this is a best of three maps. Okay, this isn't over, all right? Even if Shenton go on to actually take the point in this hybrid map, it's not over. There's still Dorado to come, there's still Nepal to come, and there's still an opportunity for this SMA1 PSKD team to bring it back to take it to a third match.
I'm excited to see Superbia on this Torbjorn. I want to see at least one hammer kill come up in the kill feed, I'll be honest. That'd be a sight to see. He's going to be playing on the high ground with the rest of his team right now, looking for some cheeky spam at the start. They have a Doomfist for the side of Shenton. Man. I love seeing good Doomfist rollouts, so they're all taking the left path right now. Perhaps looking for a dive on the high ground, or just point control. Looks like they're speeding. Up onto the high ground, Winston dives in. Looks like the Zen's going to be dropping lane for PSKD right now. Zafara is asserting her pressure with the Doomfist, gets the pick onto the Mercy. Both supports down for PSKD right now, but the counter pick onto the Mercy and the Winston for Shenton. This could potentially be a hold here. The turret gets taken down by Horny V on that D.Va, trying to pressure out the enemy D.Va on the point also, but she has the Lucio. So it looks like Shenton potentially going to be taking this one. Just need to get this baby D.Va, who is still contesting on the point. The respawns might be able to come through. Mercy about to touch with her Pharah. They're still alive on this point right now, so the Zenyatta is also here with Reaper. Reaper really asserts a lot of pressure onto the point. As you can tell, Winston already dropping low with a couple of shots from these Reaper blasters as Mercy gets taken down as well. A good pick from Tracer. As Pharah walking into a small choke like that, not the best idea against a Reaper. And excitingly, that is a hold. Let's go, PSKD. It's not over yet, baby.
So exciting to see. I mean, it was very much looking like Shenton was going to take that quite cleanly, but a few changes from PSKD coming through. They now have a Tracer. They now have a Reaper. And they're just asserting themselves on the defense of that point. They've dropped their Torbjorn and they've dropped their Sniper, their Widowmaker, which was very good because this is a very divey sort of team coming in from Shenton right now, and they took that straight off the bat.
Yeah, you can see Winston diving into the opposing backline right now on that Lucio. Lucio's dropping low, but he's wall riding around, gets taken out by the Reaper regardless. Doomfist ult coming through, Primal Rage Force by Varita right now on the point, asserting more pressure, but it looks like the kills are coming out for PSKD, have the Mercy and the D.Va down for the side of Shenton. The Winds are going to be picking up the Doomfist too, so it looks like another hold coming out for PSKD, which is very good to see. Winston trying to get out, but probably going to get staggered here. Dropping very low, they don't commit the resources to get him, don't want to stagger themselves and give Shenton an opportunity to go here, but potentially a composition switch.
Really well done from PSKD to hold off the Pharah for quite some time. The Pharah has actually had ult for the last 20 seconds. So well done to them taking out the Pharah. Rotations are looking pretty good between these two teams. PSKD not far off from having the Zenyatta ult and another Tracer ult up their sleeve as well.
And they could potentially be initiating with a Valkyrie here. Like you said, Barrage is up for the Pharah. Could be looking to just obliterate the opposing tanks, but needs the heals from his Mercy right now. Zenyatta being forced off the high ground by this Pharah, but the big Reaper ult going to be picking up the Lucio, as well as the Hog being taken down by Zen. That is three picks for the side of PSKD, but Merp says, I want this point. Please, please, just give it to me. The Transcendence coming out, going to be denying the Barrage from Merp. Merp dropping low, does pick up Zenyatta, but another swift defense, and only 40 seconds on the clock.
That is amazing.
PSKD might do this.
We may see a draw here for our first map. This is really exciting.
No, not a draw. Not a draw. A win. If they were to hold this, this would be a win.
Oh, of course.
For PSKD.
Forgive me. Transcendence coming out there. Great hold again, waiting for Merp to pull that out. They knew that the Pharaoh had that up their sleeve.
Bullman does have the beat drop though, as D.Va running in. Running into a Hog, however, so she could get D-Mech'd here, but she doesn't. The beat is still being held, but ults have to be committed on this push. The Mercy pick from Knig on that Reinhardt, along with the Zenyatta. Looks like PSKD have no support right now. This is devastating. The beat drop comes out from Shenton College as Winston trying his hardest to stall at this point. Reaper dealing damage onto the opposing tanks in the backline. Merp going to be picking up the Reaper. PSKD just do not have the players to contest this point right now. Unfortunately, they didn't have the ultimate economy. Lucio still dancing around this point, trying to contest the best he can, but they have no players to get to the point.
That'll
and Shepton, in the last push, they get the pick onto the Mercy,
wow.
And that spearheads their push. Oh, so close!
So close PSKD, between these two teams.
They just blew all their ults in the fight prior, and Shenton had the Lucio ult for that fight, so they did have the advantage. Merp gets the play of the game. Going to be getting the assist onto the Lucio, assist onto the Soldier as well. A lot of assists right now. Gets the kill onto the Baby though.
So we are, if you can see the comments rolling out right now, what we're going to do is we're going to take a bit of a pause and just little bit counts. Have an opportunity to sort what appears to be some ping issues out right now. We'll bring the camera back to us before we come back for map two, which is Dorado and the payload map. What did you like?
What did I like? Ooh. Hard to pick one thing. To pick one thing in particular.
Merp getting the play of the game there, and well-deserved as well. Merp was the Pharah on the Shenton team, and that Pharah was racking up the kills.
Yeah, for sure.
We saw one kill in particular when they were actually on defense, where managed with a rocket against the other Pharah to take her out. I mean, that is incredible tracking. And the tracking from that Pharah, I mean, worthy of the play of the game, because the tracking was very well throughout. That last map, let's talk about that last push by this Shenton team. What an extraordinary push. We saw a couple of changes there. They dropped their D.Va. They dropped their Winston as well. They picked up a Roadhog and they picked up the Reinhardt. So a little bit different. Had the hook, had the shield tank. They knew that they had to drop their Hog because obviously that Reaper was really starting to get in and do some damage.
Sure.
So one of the great things that we saw on that final that switch, right, was these two teams throughout the entire map actually changing up their teams on the fly to be able to counter what was going on against them.
Yeah, that flex onto the Reaper when PSKD was about to lose that push, and he came in and he asserted so much pressure on the point with like three shots from his blasters. He took the Winston down to like 1 HP, and the Winston gets taken out, then I think the Tracer takes out the Mercy as well. So that was a really clutch push, really clutch change coming out from PSKD, managing to hold that one.
We've got a great piece of play from these two teams as well, considering the way that they economized their ultimates.
Sure.
I mean, you saw in particular when they were watching Merp, they were pretty onto it, I reckon, SMA1 PSKD, of the Pharah on Shenton's team having their ult, you know, and thinking to themselves, oh, it's not far off. We're just going to hold the Transcendence from the Zenyatta until we need that. And we saw that Transcendence come out when Pharah popped her ult. And that's what saved them on that second last push.
Yeah, for sure. 100%.
We've got a couple of other things coming your way a little bit later on today. Remember, this is a double header that you're watching on twitch.tv/flagtest. So after Shenton Team 2 finishes up with PSKD, and we don't know which way it'll go just yet, they'll be taking on Balladura as well. As we move back into, as you can see here, powered by AOC at the top tier, SMA1 PSKD, who they're taking on right now. And then, as I mentioned, Balladura Overwatch. So Shenton Team 2 got quite the task ahead of them. And the task, because they are the only undefeated match still in the FLAC Test Regional League as we speak. Let's talk about some other things while we're waiting for these ping issues to be sorted out. We've got some information coming your way on the FLAC Test Weekly Patch. That's our weekly TV show that you see on Twitch, on YouTube, and also on Facebook. That information will be where exactly our grand finals are going to be held this year. And it is very exciting. Not just that. We've got some other huge announcements, including the sort of prizing that's going to be available for the teams playing in the grand finals, and also for Overwatch, something a little bit special from our mates over at Blizzard as well.
Oh, good old Blizz. Let's
talk about what we've got coming next, okay, between these two teams. The other two maps on the Vito, if we get that far, are Dorado and Nepal. When we were talking off camera before we fired up Twitch today, you were saying Dorado's not really one of your favorites.
Yes.
Why is that?
So I think it's because of the verticality on the streets phase of that map. It just teams either get stuck dealing with that verticality or they just manage to steamroll through with ults. I don't really see it usually go any other way. The streets phase is usually the phase that teams either hold or they get steamrolled through.
Yep. And particularly on that first corner, right? When they're coming around, I mean, for me, most of the times that I actually see it, like it's that first corner. It's either you get a good hold on the first corner just around the building. The defensive team have set themselves quite well on the vertical point. I know what you're talking about, just before you reach the bridge where a lot of holding does happen. Either that or they manage to steamroll the whole map. I personally love Dorado, right, for that particular reason, because of the verticality, because you can't just play straight through. I love the fact that as an attacking team, you've got to account for the sake of the buildings, the twists, the turns, being able to peek, being able to poke from the defensive team, and also accounting for just where they're going to be when you're actually going through the map.
Yeah, perhaps it's just as a D.Va player and having to scrim that map, I don't particularly like having to use my movement to get up onto the high ground, then just get forced down and almost demeked every single time.
Nepal.
Could just be me.
Nepal.
Nepal, love missing Nepal.
Yeah, point capture. What do you love about Nepal?
I love Nepal because I feel like there's such a difference in play between each of the particular maps. So I think it's Sanctum. Sanctum, very close quarters. You can play a variety of different comps and you can make them work no matter what. You can just brute force a point with like a Rissa Hog. You can even run dive if you speed boost around the right or left side. You can even run double sniper. Like, so many different things work on that map. It just depends on your execution. And then you run over to maps like Village, can be very Pharah favored, or even you can run something like a triple tank and just hold the point. It just allows for such a diversity of different compositions and different play styles, and that's why I like it so much, I think.
Nicely said. As we mentioned a little bit later on, Shenton and Balladura, the reason why you're seeing our mugs yet again is because we're just sorting out some ping issues. What we're going to do is we're going to take a quick break, flick over to our break screen. We'll come back in just a moment right here on Twitch. Actually, I'm getting the signal. I think we might be good to go. Is that right? As I look off camera? Ping issues appear to be fine. We appear to be already. So, all right. We've had the hybrid map, Numbani. First map out of the vetoes for Shenton and PSKD. Shenton took that out. Here's what needs to happen next. PSKD need to take out Dorado.
Yep.
Okay. That is the optimal situation for those of us that are actually watching. Let's move across to that map right now and take you into the game. And then, of course, if that happens, we get to go to the last of the best of three maps for this match, Nepal.
Hope PSK dead.
As we look around, this is what you were talking about. You can see the verticality on this map, the buildings up and down throughout the entire street system of Dorado. For me, like I said, this makes it very exciting because you have to be on your toes. You never know where those shots are coming from.
Yeah, very true. If you see dive comps being run on defense, then typically if you're a team that can execute well together, you will see the tank set up on that high ground just for some early poke or some early engages from the houses that are close to the opposing spawn. But it just depends on what they're running. It looks like they might be running a slow comp. Oh, wait, yeah, they're going to be running a slow comp as they have the Pharah. I mean, yeah, the Pharah, the Junkrat, the Reinhardt with the Zarya. Namely, the Reinhardt and the Zarya. That kind of forces a more defensive play style. As opposed to the
expect to see the first bit of verticality that we've been talking about between the, I would say probably the Zenyatta, the Hanzo, and the Reinhardt sitting up nice and high to kick things off with this point. Ben Mozzie probably going to try and take a few picks, and then a little bit lower, we'll probably see the Mercy floating around with the Zarya. And then, of course, the Pharah floating around the map to provide a little bit of splash damage. Although, as we mentioned before, Merp's been... Oh, this is interesting.
They're running pirate ship, boys.
We're doing pirate ship.
Get on board me, pirate ship.
They've got a Bastion, they've got a Torbjorn, along with the Orisa, the Mercy, and the Zenyatta. Now, if they execute this properly, it should be a clean steam.
They haven't started yet because they need the Orisa. Exactly.
There
all right,
is.
The Orisa's up.
Okay. It's okay. Heart attack stopped. Fire strike coming through. just building up towards that Earth Shatter, but it looks like the Bastion gets taken out by the Hanzo straight away. A good flank, but the Resurrect does come through, so that is going to be negated. The pick's going to be negated, rather, but the Junkrat dropping low. Merp on that Pharah getting a bit too close for comfort, so does use the Concussive Blast to get back here. Torbjorn just trying to set up that turret, as Torbjorns do, but the cart is still moving forward. Orisa dropping low, gets taken down, along with the Mercy. Leaper on that Mercy getting taken down by the Junkrat, but the picks are coming through for the Shenzhen defense right now. They're just looking for staggers. A nice headshot could take out that Zenyatta. Wasn't a headshot, but was a discorded body shot. So Zenyatta will be getting staggered there.
Look at Ben Mozzie pushing forward so far on defense.
So
he's got the confidence going, and
you know
with absolute respect to that. The Hanzo buff, those multi arrows are absolutely devastating
sure.
If you get him in the right position, taking down that turret nice and early.
PSKD deciding the pirate's life is not for them. They're swapping to a more dive-based composition.
Well, they're going to need to take out that Hanzo, get into their backline.
For sure. Punishing the Hanzo's aggressive positioning could mean the difference between taking this point and not. The Hanzo does have the pocket with the Mercy in the top left right now. Could be looking for the flanks. Oh, actually, no, it's the Pharmacy, rather. The Hanzo are going to be coming down through the middle, forcing the tanks back. Two picks going to be coming out from PSKD. The Pharmacy is down. I repeat, the Pharmacy is down. The D.Va getting de-mecked. Zenyatta going to be taken down by the McCree, I believe. Zarya building up that energy nicely. Doesn't have the bubble to protect his Hanzo, but Winston going to be missing his charge. So Hanzo going to be taken down.
And PSKD. Oh, no. Did you see what just happened there?
No, I didn't.
Nig went for the hammer down. He went for the right hard ult. And they got him before he got it all the way down, which means he's gone ult reset right now without being able to get it off. That means him and Hanzo, ineffective ults there. This will be a PSKD.
Zarya on the point right now, 91% on that Graviton Surge. She could get a huge Graviton, but doesn't have the combo as Pharah is down. The Transcendence coming out from Shenzhen on the point, keeping the members alive. D.Va has been de-mecked, and it looks like the point is being stabilized right now as McCree getting the pick onto the Mercy.
But
it doesn't matter because they just have the pick advantage for the side of Shenzhen.
Alt advantage right now.
Oh no, the Mercy inside the left room. Mercy versus Hanzo. Who's going to come out on top? No one's helping the Hanzo right now. He might just fall. The Mercy is on 1 HP. Hanzo dropping low, trying to get out, but the 5 ball from the Zenyatta going to be taking down the Mercy. Oh my goodness. If Hanzo loses that duel, that is... That would have been quite... Oh, no! Was that a fat finger?
I think that's a fat finger. That is not when you want to be dropping your Transcendence.
No.
He's not going to be happy about that. Mind you, the Junkrat on 95% for his ult. They have 44 seconds to get back on the payload.
Very
ult
true.
Advantage to Shenzhen right now.
They have the Hanzo Graviton Surge combo right now. So if that's executed, or alternatively, they could use the Rocket Barrage. Oh, no. A nice pick coming up from Ben Mozzie. Gets the arrows onto the Zen, gets the pick, but he does just get rezzed up. They don't push the advantage to negate that rez. Junkrat potentially looking for an angle on this time.
Winston ult up in a couple of seconds.
PSKD, they have the resources right now, and they decide they are going to expend them. The Winston in the back line right now, but the Tyre gets two, gets the Reinhardt along with the Zen. Winston looks like he lost the Hanzo right there, but that's because he got taken out by the Mercy. Leepo on the Mercy also going to be taken down. And PSKD, they used the resources
well. Wow. Okay.
The Junkrat Tyre got the two picks.
Yeah,
and that
exactly.
Very well.
That was the Junkrat Tyre. That was all the Junkrat Tyre. It managed to get them down the Zarya, who had ult ready to go. And you were talking about
massive.
That ult combo between the Zarya and the Hanzo. Hanzo was the only thing left. And of course, their dive comp from PSKD was able to get into that back line and take that Hanzo out.
So Shenzhen probably looking to use their ultimates and stabilize the defense right now, as they do definitely have the ultimate economy advantage. And Merp picks up two, no ult required, he says, but McCree gets the pick onto Ben Mozzie. But McCree trying to duel the Pharah, but you can't really duel the Pharah very well if she does have the pocket with the Mercy and the orb. So that's Merp just taking his team, shoving them on his back, and gets more picks to follow. But he drops low, doesn't have his Mercy with him. Perhaps some miscommunication there. Zarya trying to back up, trying to keep his Reinhardt and Zenyatta alive. But the card just keeps moving forward. They still have the Graviton Surge along with the Hanswald. They're going to be needing to expend that here. But the Winston does get taken down by Ben Mozzie on that Hanzo, getting heaps of picks this game. And here comes the combo. You can't survive that one. Why did they drop the Diva Bomb? It is made redundant.
It was the wrong time for the combo, though. I've got to say it was the wrong time for the combo. You know, they just dropped two alts that they could have saved for something a little bit more important with 60 seconds left to go. And all they got was one pick out of it. That was it.
Potentially, sometimes expending your ults to get a nice stabilizing fight for your team.
That
it can be good sometimes.
That is
a huge headshot coming out from Hanzo, completely negating the high noon that could have got two if that shot had a miss. Looks like a nice vibe ball coming out from the Bullman onto the Mercy. And Shenton.
Oh, wow.
Just from some beautiful individual play, going to be holding this one. And they have built up Ben Mozzie's Dragon Strike yet again. They also have both support ults along with the Pharah Barrage.
Okay, but we have equal amount of ults on PSKD as
Very
well.
True.
They've got the Winston ult that they can pull out to be able to get onto that nice and easy. A quick Rip. Jump.
You hear that? Riptire coming in. He's going across the high ground right now, looking for the pick onto the Valking Mercy. Valking Mercy down, boys. Like SWAT in the fly. Transcendence forced by the Reinhardt. Barrage comes through. The opposing trance also coming through. Winston being kept alive, but Zen being smacked around on the point. Horny V on that Zarya going to be getting the pick. Shenton, three picks up right now. Diva trying to contest the point. We are in overtime right now. Diva gets D-Mex, walks into the dragon. Ben Mozzie getting another pick here. And looks like Shenton, like I said, you either steamroll through it or you get held.
Wow. What did we just see? I'm tired.
You're tired? We're only two games. This is only our second game. Not even done.
That was one of the most incredible pieces of defensive play I've ever...
Hot dang.
Hot dang I've ever watched. Oh, the... I mean, look, we saw a great example of being able to time and not time particular things happening in this game right. You know, on this early stage of the point, we saw the Reinhardt go to drop his ult. As Shenton were defending, and they managed to take him down as he was bringing the hammer down, which means he had ult reset. And then in the second stage of this map, we saw the McCree stumble out, pull out his ult, and then an incredible Hanzo shot to the head from Ben Mozzie negated that.
It's hard.
That is just heartbreaking. Oh, wow. Yeah. I mean, I'm a Reinhardt main, so I've been on the end of plenty of times where I've been about to drop ult and then I've had it reset on me because they've just managed to drop me at the right time. And that is, absolutely heartbreaking. But look, you know what? 61.8 meters to go in that second place for the attacking team for PSKD when they were attacking is not a bad place to be. It's not.
For
at
sure.
this level of game, it's not a bad place to be. What they need to do now is get Shenton to overtime.
Yeah, PSKD were full held last time and they brought it to the very last
That's right.
fight. They really took it to the wire. So they might be able to do it again here.
So I reckon we're going to see another pirate ship on the attack this time around. Shenton have Merp, who's just been so dominating up in the air, but also the Orisa, the Reinhardt, so dual shields for Ben Mozzie to be able to get on that payload and do his thing.
But Luxuria is on the Reaper and is in the backline. Nobody knows he's here right now. So
good.
He could be able to blow up the Bastion. He sees the Pharmacy. He goes after the Mercy. Mercy dropping really low. Will he be able to get the pick? Mercy fighting back though, pulls out the pistol, but Luxuria getting the pick on the Mercy, so they're surely going to have to wait for the Mercy to respawn unless they get some more huge picks as Merp getting the D-Mech onto the opposing D.Va. But Soldier going to be taking out the pirate ship king himself, Bastion. But the payload is still moving forward, no one's contesting. Reinhardt pins the Orisa, huge pin, going to be taken down. The Orisa there is Reinhardt just swinging away right now, trying to build up his ultimate as the payload is stopped.
Good stop there from PSKD. That was a fairly good team fight between these two. The Reaper just having an opportunity to take out that Mercy. That was a nice way to start this match for PSKD on the on defense.
K'Neg right now on the Reinhardt does have his Earth Shatter and Dorita. He's 94 to his. So we should be seeing some Reinhardt mind games right now. Who gets the shatter first? It looks like it's going to be Shenton's Reinhardt as the D.Va gets pinned. Reaper trying to take out the Bastion, but Ben Mozzie is just too powerful, this man. The Resurrect comes out onto the Reinhardt. He just decides to pin in here. He's like, why have you brought me back, brother? Why have you forsaken me? Zenyatta going to have to get out here with the Mercy Pocket. Looks like this point is going to be steamrolling through. As you can't really contest, you can't stagger onto a point if Bastion is here. And Mercy dropping a half HP. Merp on the Pharah gets the pick with the help of the Orisa. Gula right now needs to get out. Can't get staggered right now. You need to shift away, son. Fly away, fly away. His 50 HP is dropping low. They decide to take the low ground, just try and scare the opposing. They do have the Earth Shatter.
It's very dangerous for PSKD right now. As you can see, we can see where Shenton need to get this point to with 4 minutes still on the board for Shenton. Someone needs to stop Merp
on this Pharah, man. Look at him. He's demolishing the backline. Gets four. Looks like the soldier on the high ground trying to fix the mistakes of his team with a 6K, but that isn't going to happen. And they steamroll through the second phase. Shenton Team 2 wins 2-0.
Let's see this play of the game. It's got to be Merp.
It's got to be Merp.
It's got to be Merp.
Here it is. Flying down from the heavens.
Wow. Oh, yeah.
Gets the D.Va. Has the barrage. Gets the Reaper that uses his E onto the high ground. A huge barrage. Can you pick it up? 1, 2, 3. They all fall like dominoes. You hear the visor, but it was redundant. Quite unfortunate. 55% kill participation. He will get the card for this round. And 7, 8, 9. Can we get a 10?
We got a 10.
We got a legendary card for Merp. Well deserved from him.
Very well deserved. There you go. 55% kill participation, which leads me to my next point. Who stops Merp? Like, that's, if you're Balajura, you know, there's a good chance that you could be watching that stream right now waiting for your game, which is about to come up, by the way. And you're thinking to yourself, who stops Merp? We're going to just take a quick break and we'll come back on twitch.tv/flaktest to wrap that match and then take us into the next of the double headers for Shenton versus Balajura.